Today at Speedy's Garage, we're going to install some level 5 1400 horsepower axles from the drive shaft shop on a Project Orange Crush. To install the axles, if you don't have access to a lift, you're going to need a jack and two jack stands. Here are the tools you're going to need to install the axles. 15 millimeter, 16 millimeter, 18 millimeter, and 21 millimeter crescent wrenches. 15 and 18 millimeter sockets, as well as a 10 millimeter, a torque wrench that will go to at least 157 foot-pounds. The inch-pound torque wrench is optional, but you can use it on the 10 millimeter speed sensor bolt. You'll need a strong half-inch drive socket wrench, breaker bar. I'm going to use some air tools, so I've got my air ratchet, my impact gun. There's a couple of special tools you're going to need. One is that T30 Torx for the parking brake cable. You'll need a 32 millimeter or 1.25 inch socket for the axle nut, a 12 millimeter Allen socket. You'll need a piece of wood or a piece of plastic to tap off the tone rings, a pry bar to remove the stock axles, and a hammer, plastic hammer like that. It's weighted, comes in handy to remove the knuckle, and a punch to help you line the bolt holes back up. Another special tool you might need is an 8 millimeter Allen socket to tighten the bolts on the level 5 axles. Start by getting the car in the air so you can remove the tires. After you remove the tires and wheels, remove the brake caliper, remove your brake disc and your spindle nut. Disconnect the ABS cable and the lower sway bar end link. Next, disconnect all the control arm bolts here, here, here. So on the back side of that bracket, that is a 12 millimeter Allen wrench socket. Once you have the side spindle disconnected, you'll need to pry the axle out of the differential first. Once you get the stock axles out of the car, make sure to compare them, passenger side and driver's side, because one is longer than the other. And on my level 5 axles, they were actually labeled incorrectly. You want to have the long side be on the right, or passenger side, and the shorter axle goes on the left, or driver's side. Next, you need to remove the tone ring off the stock axle and install it on the upgraded axle. You want to be careful with this part. You can't buy it separately, so if you damage it, you'll have to buy a whole new stock axle to replace it. So you want to use something soft, like a piece of pine and a light tap, you know, from your hammer, to slide that off. And then just tap the tone ring on your new axle, being careful not to damage it. You do need to come back and tighten these bolts to 57 foot-pounds before installing the axle. Once you've torqued your bolts on the axle to 57 foot-pounds, put some grease on the axle splines on the diff side, and don't forget about your washer that goes on the hub side. The axles just snap back into the differential, and then you slide your hub over top of the axle. On the back side of your hub, you'll notice a small sleeve that looks like it protrudes. You can tap that back just a smidge, and it'll help the hub go back on the car much more easily. And then when you tighten the bolt from the other side, it will actually push that sleeve back to its original position. Tapping that bushing back and hitting the edge of that grommet with a little sanding wheel will give you some clearance to slide the bracket back on the hub assembly. That's probably the hardest part of the install right there. After reseating the hub, start by installing your 12 millimeter Allen bolt that goes through the bottom. You'll have to muscle it in place to get the bushings and grommets to line up. Next, you'll install your lower control arm bolt. Next, install your upper control arm bolt, but make sure the brake caliper is on the outside of that bar right here so that you can get it back on the hub assembly. Once you get all the bolts started, then tighten them down. You got your upper control arm, lower control arm, your sway bar end link. Don't forget about your ABS sensor. Put that in. And if you had to disconnect the parking brake, reconnect that. Before you reinstall the caliper, go ahead and double check the torque on all your fasteners. Start with the 12 millimeter Allen bolt And the bolt on the back side of it's a 21 millimeter. Torque setting is 102 foot-pounds. Next, go ahead and torque your upper control arm link bolt. The manual actually calls it a camber link, and it's an 18 millimeter bolt on each side. And the torque setting is 72 foot-pounds. Next, you want to tighten your tension link bolts. It's an 18 millimeter bolt, an 18 millimeter nut to 72 foot-pounds. Then you want to tighten your toe link, which is also an 18 millimeter bolt and nut, to 60 foot-pounds. Finally, you want to tighten the compression link, which is the one at the very bottom, bolt and nut, they're 18 millimeter, to 60 foot-pounds as well. Next, slide on your rotor. Reattach your caliper using the 18 millimeter caliper bracket bolts, and the torque on those is 85 foot-pounds. Next, install the axle nuts and tighten them down to 157 foot-pounds. Now attach your sway bar end link, and it's actually a 15 millimeter bolt with a 16 millimeter nut, and you torque it to 45 foot-pounds. The 10 millimeter wheel speed sensor bracket bolt gets tightened to 97 inch-pounds. Be very careful here, it's inch-pounds, not foot-pounds. This one's a little hard to show you, but the parking brake nut right there is actually a Torx bit, and it's a T30. So you're gonna need something like that to tighten it. The torque setting is 72 inch-pounds, but I just tightened it down good and snug. Finally, just reinstall your wheels, tighten your lug nuts to 110 foot-pounds, and that's it. One thing I wanted to note for the upgraded axle install is that the axle nut goes on this threaded shaft here, and it'll feel like it's cross-threading when you're installing it on the new axle. It's tight going on. It's the design of the axle nut. It's actually a safety feature to keep it from backing off. So you just have to run it down with an impact or something and get it, you know, when you get it down close, and then torque it to 157 foot-pounds once you have it fully seated. I actually called the drive shaft shop to confirm the threads on the upgraded axle were the same as the stock ones, because I thought maybe the threads were changed, and they did confirm it's M22 by 1.5, which is the same as stock. It's just tight, and you have to really work on it to get it to crank down. My final thoughts on the drive shaft shop level 5 axle upgrade is that the install is actually relatively straightforward. I did rent rack space at a local performance shop in order to do the install on a lift, and that made the install much easier. It took about 2.5 hours start to finish, and it was very straightforward. The lift makes it easy to get to things and able to get your leverage on your bolts when you need to. Some of the suspension bolts are pretty tight. Air tools obviously help a lot, or cordless impact type guns. Those came in very handy. 2.5 hours, if you're doing this in your driveway on jack stands, probably double that time. It'll probably take you 4 or 5 hours due to the difficulty in getting to everything. So if you have the opportunity to use a rack, I would definitely go that route. It'll make the install much more enjoyable. Everything went well, and I'm very happy with the upgrade. I recommend you keep the stock axles as spares just in case. Just be sure to mark them as you take them off the car. The shorter one is the driver's side or left side, and the longer one is the right side or passenger side. I want to thank Agent Automotive in Mount Juliet, Tennessee, for helping me with the install and letting me use their rack space. And if you want to see more information on Project Orange Crush, visit my website, www.speedysgarage.net.